Hi folks, Nathan Seidel, founder of Sparkfun Electronics, here today with another GNSS update. We've got an interesting one. We're out in the field with no cell phone reception, demonstrating how you can still achieve an RTK fix with an internet-connected briefcase. Let's go inside and we'll talk a little more about that black box right over there. So today we're going to talk about getting internet in the field in areas where you may not have cellular reception. With GNSS receivers, to get that high-precision RTK fix, you often need a connection to the internet to get those corrections over NTRIP back down to the device. Customarily, that has been L-band, but that is going away with U-blocks at the end of 2025, and so our customers on the forum were talking about using Starlink. So today we're going to talk about Starlink in a briefcase. There are two different current satellite terminals for Starlink, the standard Starlink and then the Starlink Roam. We chose Roam because it is smaller, fits into a briefcase, and just generally more portable. However, currently it's a little more expensive than that larger terminal. Your mileage may vary. In our testing, we found that the device has a 12 to 48 volt input, which is really nice because we can provide it with a bunch of different sources. In this case, we're using a lithium iron phosphate battery, as well as a fancy power button and a power display to show you what's going on. We've also got a little external charging port. We flipped the antenna upside down so it's facing up. And again, in our testing, we found that the device works just fine with the case closed, set outside. So if you're doing any kind of surveying where you need to get internet connectivity for your phone or your RTK device, you can set this outside, press the button, and within a couple minutes, have internet connectivity. Now, we went kind of fancy with the carrying case. This was a collection of parts, about $100-$150. You don't need all this to operate in the field. Let's go into some of the specifics about how you could do a setup even cheaper. So on the back of all Starlink terminals is a 12 to 48 volt DC input. Now, whatever decisions they've made, I really appreciate this one because they chose a 5.5 by 2.1 millimeter barrel jack that's center positive. Now, that's a lot of stuff. It's the most common power connector in the world. So that means you can find all sorts of accessories. You don't need any kind of crazy Starlink cable. You don't need any kind of specially designed thing. These are a dime a dozen. So just be sure that you find a 5.5 by 2.1 millimeter barrel jack that is center positive to provide power to your Starlink terminal, 12 to 48 volts. In this case, our battery, being lithium iron phosphate, outputs about 13 volts, and that works great. Now, one of the pitfalls that I hit early on was using the original Starlink cable. So this guy is about 30 feet long. Now, if we hook up our approximately 12 volt battery across a 30 volt cable, we have enough voltage drop where the terminal will go into kind of brownout and constant reset. It doesn't work. So we cannot use this cable with a 12 volt battery. Instead, we can use really simple cables with really fantastic batteries for just a couple bucks. The cable being a couple dollars, the battery, these are coming down in price. These are $30, $40. You can find them pretty much anywhere, and varying sizes and weights and capacities. Our little 10 amp hour battery runs our terminal for about four and a half hours. Bigger batteries will run for longer. We'll post our schematic for the wiring harness that we developed online. It's really simple. But the point being is that it just makes it really simple to operate this device in the field. Now let's talk about the service or the cost of using Starlink Roam in the field. If you're gonna watch YouTube and if you're gonna hit the internet and do all sorts of craziness, it's about $50 a month for a 50 gigabyte. Prices will change. But what we found is that for RTK service, we don't need that 50 gigabyte. That's a ton of data. Instead, Starlink currently has an option to pause your service for $5 a month. Sounds fine. What we found in the small print was that for that $5 a month, you get 500 kilobits per second to do messaging and sort of safety connections and any kind of back. Well, guess what? 500 kilobits per second is still a tremendous amount of information and is more than enough to handle the amount of data to move across the link for NTRIP. So NTRIP uses 1 kilobyte per second, 2 kilobyte per second. You've got 50 kilobyte per second. It's more than enough. So once you invest in the hardware, it's $5 a month to have internet anywhere in the world for your high precision RTK network. So if you're considering doing high precision GNSS work, whether it's surveying or measuring or doing anything in the field where you're worried about having connectivity to the internet, consider using Starlink as a backup for those really remote areas where you may not be covered.